Hello children, welcome to AIIMS India's online classes, biology session, nutrition in animals. So we have completed the lesson. In today's class, let us discuss the questions which appeared in the previous contests from this lesson. So before going to the exercise, let us have a brief recap. So what is a nutrition? The process of procurement of nutrients is called nutrition. And what are nutrients? Nutrients are a source of nourishment, such as food that can be metabolized by an organism to give energy and build tissue. Or we can simply define nutrient as the chemical substances which help in energy production and growth. Okay, so energy is produced by a process called catabolism. What is catabolism? It is a destructive metabolism. It includes the release of energy and breakdown of materials. So in the lesson we have studied different aspects like ingestion, digestion and absorption, assimilation and digestion. Along with that, we come across some terms like mastication, means the process of chewing, and the substance partly digested food which is formed in the mouth is called bolus. The partly digested food in the stomach is called chyme. The partly digested food in the intestine, okay, it is called chyle, isn't it? So the different aspects we have studied and the total nutrition in animals we have completed. From unicellular organisms to multicellular animals, the process of digestion. For example, in amoeba, digestion takes place inside the food vacuole. Whereas in higher multicellular animals, it is extracellular digestion. Okay? So are you ready, children? Let us discuss briefly the questions which are repeated in the previous Olympiad, NEET and other contests from this lesson. The first question: the animals which eat only plants are called carnivores, herbivores, omnivores, or all of these. So what do you call the animals which eat only plants? The animals which eat only plants are called herbivores. Next, the animals which eat only animals are called, or flesh, are called carnivores. The animals which eat both plants and animals are called omnivores. The process of taking food into the body is called, there are five main steps which are there in the nutrition in multicellular animals. They are ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation and digestion. So the process of taking food into the body is called ingestion. Different feeding mechanisms we have studied. So how amoeba take its food? With the help of pseudopodia. How paramecium take its food? With the help of cilia. How hydra take its food? With the help of tentacles, isn't it? So different animals use the different organs. They are called organs of feeding, the feeding mechanism. So next question: the process in which food containing large insoluble molecules is broken down into small water soluble molecules is called okay, digestion, ingestion, absorption, assimilation. So it is a process of digestion in which the large insoluble molecules of food particles broken down into small soluble molecules. Next, the process in which the digested food passes through the intestinal wall into bloodstream is called, what do you call that process? Digestion, ingestion, absorption, assimilation. So here after digestion in the small intestine, the ileum of small intestine consisting of several finger-like projections which are richly supplied with the blood capillaries. Okay, so this is called what do you call that process? Absorption. Okay, the process in which the digested food passes through the intestinal wall into bloodstream, it is called absorption. Next, the process in which the absorbed food is taken in by the body and cells and used for energy, growth and repair is called digestion, ingestion, absorption, assimilation. What do you call that process? Assimilation. Utilization of digested food materials for energy production, growth and repair is called as assimilation. Next, the enzyme present in the gastric juice, HCl, pepsin, amylase, mucin. So here the enzymes too, pepsin, amylase are there, out of which the main enzyme, the only enzyme present in the gastric juice is pepsin, which acts on proteins. The greenish yellow liquid made in the liver and stored in gallbladder is hydrochloric acid, enzymes, bile, ptyalin. So it is the bile juice which is produced in the liver and stored in the gallbladder temporarily. The digestive juice without enzymes is pancreatic juice, saliva, intestinal juice, bile. Bile is the digestive juice without any enzymes. Then what is the function of bile? There are no enzymes, but we are calling it as digestive juice. The main function of this bile juice is the emulsification of fats. What is emulsification? The process of conversion of complex fats, fat molecules into microcolloidal substances is called as emulsification. Bile salts, that is bilirubin and biliverdin, involved in the emulsification of fats. So next question. Which of the following helps in digestion in amoeba? The pseudopodia, cytoplasm, nucleus, food vacuole. Food vacuoles. Okay. So the pseudopodia surround the prey and ingest the prey. After that, around the prey a vacuole is formed, that is called the food vacuole. Inside the food vacuole there are the hydrolytic enzymes which are present, helps in the process of digestion. This kind of digestion is called as a intracellular digestion, takes place in amoeba, where inside the food vacuole. So in which of the following parts of the elementary canal the complete digestion and absorption of the food takes place? Once again, in which of the following parts of elementary canal the complete digestion and absorption of the food takes place? Large intestine, small intestine, oesophagus, stomach. It is the small intestine where the maximum digestion and the absorption of the food takes place. this small intestine is divided into three main parts. What are those three main parts of the small intestine? One is duodenum, second part jejunum, third part is ileum. The maximum digestion takes place in the duodenum. Okay, then in the ileum, total digestion completes and the products are absorbed. Next question. Which of the following represents the teeth marked Q in the given figure? Please observe the figure here. It is the jaw, our jaw. PQRS. Each half of the jaw containing different types of teeth. What does the Q represent? The four main types of teeth present in our jaw are incisors, canines, premolars and molars. Okay, the P represent incisors, Q represent canines and R represents premolar and S represents the molar. Okay, so here the Q represent canines. What is the function of canines, children? The four types of teeth perform four types of function. The first one is the incisors. Incisors help in cutting the food. Canines help in the tearing of food. And premolars and molars help in grinding and chewing the food. So here Q represent which type of teeth? Canines. Which of the following is the correct sequence of human nutrition? The five main steps are there, no? Correct sequence. What are those five main steps? Ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation and egestion. So here the correct sequence is option D. Ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation and egestion. Which of the following labeled parts stores cud in ruminants? Cud means the partially digested food. So in the ruminants stomach, it is a peculiar stomach which is divided into how many chambers? Four chambers. Let us recall the names of those four chambers. That is rumen, reticulum, omasum, abomasum. Rumen, reticulum, omasum, abomasum. So the cud is stored in the which part labeled here in the image? PQRS. So it is the Q in which the food is, the cud is stored temporarily. So which statement about the large intestine is false? False means wrong. Here the statements, four statements I will read out. The first one, no absorption of materials takes place in the given organ. First part of the given organ is called colon. The length of the organ is 1.5 meters. It secretes mucus, out of which is a false statement. The false statement is A. No absorption of materials takes place in the given organ. So we are saying that it is wrong. Then what is right? Absorption of some water which is present in the undigested food takes place in the large intestine. Okay. Next, which of the following is the largest gland in human body? In our body, which is the largest organ? Pancreas, stomach, kidney, liver. Liver is the largest organ present in our body. It acts like a factory. It performs several functions. Okay. So liver is very important organ, the largest organ, largest gland present in our body. Which part of the alimentary canal is most acidic? Colon, ileum, mouth, stomach. Acid is produced in which organ of our digestive system? So it is the stomach which produces the HCl. So most acidic nature is present inside the stomach. Which statement is correct about the villi? Okay, what are villi? Villi are the finger-like projections present in the ileum of the small intestine. So the statements are given here. Let us find out which of the statement is correct about the villi. It increases the surface area for absorption of food. The first one. It decreases the surface area of absorption of food. The third statement, it protects the lining of the small intestine. It protects the lining of the stomach. So the first statement seems to be correct. It increases the surface area of absorption of food. What happens to the food when it enters stomach from esophagus? Here also the four statements are given. Food mixes with the juices and digestion of carbohydrates starts. So we have to select such a statement which represents the digestion of food in the stomach. Okay. The first statement is food mixes with the juices and the digestion of carbohydrates start. Second statement, food mixes with the juices and digestion of protein starts. Third statement, food quickly moves into small intestine. The fourth statement, food quickly moves into large intestine. So here the food mixes with the juices and the digestion of protein start. Pepsin enzyme is present, no, in the stomach or in the gastric juice that acts upon the proteins and helps in the digestion of proteins. Partial digestion of proteins takes place in the stomach as soon as the food enters into the stomach from esophagus. Next, which of the following are the characteristics of enzymes? Enzymes are called biocatalysts. Why they are called biocatalysts? So here some statements are given. We have to select the statement which truly represent the action of enzymes. First one, enzymes are the substances which are broken into smaller substances during digestion. Means the equation, the sentence giving the meaning, enzymes are some substrates. Second one, the substances which are made by the combination of carbohydrates. Statement 3, substances which break complex food molecules into simpler food molecules. Next, the fourth one, the substances which break complex substances and they themselves undergo dissociation reactions. Okay, so here the third statement is clearly giving or explaining about the enzymes. Enzymes are the substances which break complex food molecules into simpler food molecules, means that is they involve in the process of digestion without undergoing any change. They are biocatalysts. They does not undergo any change. They enhance the reaction. They help in the reaction to proceed, but they doesn't undergo any change. Okay. So enzymes are the substances which break the complex food molecules into simplest. That's why we will write the enzyme on the arrow mark. Okay, children. For example, starch in the mouth is acted upon by, gives rise to, on the arrow mark we will write salivary amylase or tylin enzyme. Okay, convert the starch into maltose sugar. Starch is a complex sugar. It is converted into simplest sugar, maltose, in the presence of which enzyme? Ptyalene. So enzymes not directly involved in the reaction, but they acts like a catalyst and help in the process of reaction without undergoing any change. That's why these enzymes require some medium. Certain enzymes are active in the acidic medium, certain enzymes are active in the basic medium. Okay, we are calling it as pH. Okay, the pH help the activity, will decide the activity of enzymes. There are three main factors which represent. One is optimum temperature, second one amount of substrate, third one is pH. Okay children, you will study about these enzymes in the higher classes. Which of the following is the correct description of assimilation? So these are all knowledge recall type questions. What is assimilation? If you remember, you can answer. Okay, so I will read out the statements. The process of breaking large food molecules into simpler molecules. The second statement, the process by which undigested food is ejected out of the body. The third statement, the process by which the digested food carried by the blood is taken in by the cells of the body. The fourth statement, the process of interexchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide between hemoglobin and the cells of the body. Okay, here clearly explained or clearly given. The A option represents the process of digestion. B option represents the process of egestion or defecation. And the D option represents the respiration, exchange of gases. But the C option is the actual which represents the process of assimilation. What is assimilation? The process by which the digested food carried by the blood is taken in by the cells of the body. Okay. Next. Which statement is true about peristalsis, or what is peristalsis? The wearing out of color on the parts of leaves due to lack of carbon dioxide and chlorophyll. The process of breaking of large food molecules into simpler food molecules by amylase enzyme. The movement of food through alimentary canal by the wave-like movement controlled by involuntary muscles. Or the process by which the digested food is carried by the blood to different cells. Okay. So here the oesophagus is the tube-like structure, opens into the stomach. Before the food opens into the stomach, okay, how the food is entered into the stomach? By means of swallowing, a process called swallowing. So once we swallow the food in the esophagus, a wave-like movement takes place like this. So this wave-like movement in the esophagus which push the food from esophagus into the stomach. Okay, this is called peristalsis. So this is called the peristalsis. The process of the movement of the food from esophagus or food pipe into the stomach. Okay, so here option C, the movement of food through alimentary canal by the wave-like movement controlled by involuntary muscles is called peristalsis. Peristalsis movement is shown by which part of alimentary canal? Which part of alimentary canal shows peristalsis? Esophagus or food pipe. Next. So functional units of food absorption are villi, Brunner's gland, or crypts of Leberkohn, crypts of Lebrecrohan or Peyer's patches. So here villi represent they are singular, of which the villus, if you take the finger like projections in the small intestine that help to absorb the food from more efficiently in the body. Okay, so here the answer is A. Then what are Brunner's glands? What are Peyer's patches? Okay. Just briefly I will tell you. Actually you will learn about these things in higher classes. Okay. There are several things are there in the nutrition in animals. Okay. There are different types of cells are present in the digestive system. Okay. Let us know about the options given here. Okay. So let us spend 1 or 2 minutes. Brunner's glands are found in the part of the digestive system known as the duodenum. What is duodenum? Duodenum is the part of small intestine, isn't it? So what is the function of this Brunner's gland is they secrete mucus and bicarbonates. Very important function. They secrete mucus and bicarbonates in order to neutralize the hydrochloric acid which is produced in the stomach. Because the enzymes which are present in the intestinal juice or the enzymes which show action of digestion in the duodenum, they need basic medium somewhat. So the duodenum secrete mucus and bicarbonates. Okay, what is that gland present in the duodenum? Brunner's gland. Okay, remember children. Next, crypts of Lebrecrohan. Okay, crypts of Lebrecrohan, where they are present. Okay, crypts of Lebrecrohan is also the special type of cells which are present in the intestine. Okay. Next, Peyer's patches. What are Peyer's patches? Peyer's patches are found in the small intestine. Okay. They are found in the small intestine. They are small masses of lymphatic tissue. They are found throughout the ileum region. Ileum region means the terminal part of small intestine. Okay. Peyer's patches. And some other cells are also present. Oxyntic cells. Okay. They are also called parietal cells which are present in the stomach. And they secrete gastric juice. Okay. Next, zymogen cells. So these zymogen cells are also they are also present in the gastric glands only. Gastric juice they produce. Okay. These are the cells which are present in the stomach that release two important enzymes. Which cells? Zymogen cells. That is pepsinogen and chymotrypsinogen. Pepsinogen and chymotrypsinogen. Pepsinogen itself is converted into pepsin in the presence of hydrochloric acid. Okay, chymotrypsinogen is converted into chymotrypsin. Okay. So if the stomach, the pH is 7, below 7 actually, below 7 is acidic. If it is the pH is above 7, it is basic. Okay. Okay, children, let us proceed. Question number 25. One of the following is not an enzyme of digestive system. One of the following is not an enzyme of digestive system. That is trypsin, amylase, enterogastrone and enterokinase. Okay. A, B and D are the enzymes of digestive system. Enterogastrone is a hormone. It is not an enzyme. Okay. Next, this length of small intestine and large intestine are respectively. Okay. So what is the length of small intestine and large intestine? So that is the 7.5 meters is the length of large intestine. No, length of small intestine. And 1.5 meters is the length of a large intestine. So option A, one only is correct. So which statement is correct? Here the four statements are given. You need to select the right statement out of four. Breakdown of complex substance into simpler substance is called peristalsis, which is wrong. Next, the process of passing of digestive food into blood vessels in the intestine is called peristalsis. It is also wrong. The movement of the food through alimentary canal by a wave-like movement controlled by involuntary muscles is called peristalsis. So it seems to be correct. The process of utilization of glucose amino acids is called peristalsis. It is also wrong. So here the correct statement is number 2. Which is not true for villi? These increase the surface area of absorption of the digested food. Okay. Okay, this is, you have to select here. Wrong statement you have to select. This is true. These are small finger-like projections. Okay, true. Villi protects the inner lining of stomach. So actually villi are present in the ileum of the small intestine. So it is wrong. Then they absorb the digested food materials. Okay, it's true. So here also the wrong statement is the third statement, option C. Once again, same type of question. Which one is incorrect about liver? It stores proteins and fats. It stores proteins and fats. Okay, true. It purifies blood. No, blood is purified by kidneys. It removes and stores iron from dead red blood cells. So it is also wrong. It helps in the digestion of digestion by producing the bile. Actually here it is uncertain statement. Of course it helps in the process of digestion, but digestion of fat is not mentioned clearly. So here the statement 1 is only correct. Okay. Next, assertion and reasoning type questions. So these are the different types of questions which appear in the previous contests, competitive exams. Okay. So assertion, large intestine also shows the presence of villi like small intestine. Reason, absorption of water takes place in large intestine. Okay. Here, absorption of water takes place in the large intestine. Here, both the statements are not showing the clarity. So actually statement A is absolutely wrong, and means assertion is absolutely wrong. Reason is correct, but reason is not explaining the, okay, reason is totally, it is correct, but the assertion is totally wrong. Okay, so both are not true. Next, 31. Digested food material is absorbed in the intestine through the process of diffusion. Reason, Diffusion is a very fast process of absorption. Diffusion is a very fast process of absorption. Yes. Okay, here both assertion and reasoning are true. And reason is exactly explaining the assertion. Okay. Next. The stomach mucosa is not digested by its own secretions. Reason. Mucin coats the mucosa of stomach. Absolutely correct. Okay. Means both assertion and reasoning are right. And the reason is explaining the assertion, supporting the assertion correctly. Because hydrochloric acid which is produced in the stomach may digest or damage the wall of the stomach, but it does not happen because the mucin coats. Okay, mucin and the mucus. Mucin means nothing but mucus is produced that protects the wall of the stomach. The special cells are present. Next. An elephant tusk is a modified upper incisor. Reason. The tusk of elephant is used in food uptaking. Here also both assertion and reason are correct, and reason is explaining correctly the assertion. Okay. Next. Match the following type. So it appeared in the Kerala PMT pre-medical test. KPMT it is called in 2007. Small intestine. Large intestine, buccal cavity, ingestion. Next, in the column 2, 7.5, 1.5, part of elementary canal and the process of taking food into the body. So here, small intestine length 7.5 meters, large intestine length 1.5 meters. The buccal cavity is a part of elementary canal or oral cavity, it is called. Ingestion means the process of taking in of a food. So here P, Q, R, S. Option A is correct. Next, food pipe, elementary canal, stomach, widest part of elementary canal, digestive tract, oesophagus, flattened U shape in the stomach. Okay. So here, food pipe, it is also called oesophagus. Next, elementary canal. Elementary canal is nothing but the digestive tract. Stomach. The stomach is a flattened U-shaped sac-like structure. The widest part of elementary canal is a stomach. Okay. So, AQ, BP, CR, DS. Option C is correct. Okay, these are the, once again, the questions which appeared from the previous contests. Which one of the following is the correct matching of the site of action on the given substrate? The enzyme acting upon it and the end product. Here, organ is given, substrate is given, enzyme and product is given. So the four options, which one is correctly matching? Okay. Stomach, fats, lipase, micellus. So this is wrong. Duodenum, triglycerides, trypsin, monoglycerides. This is also wrong. Small intestine, starch, amylase, disaccharides, maltose. Okay, it's correct. Small intestine, proteins, pepsin, amino acid. So actually this is also takes place in the mouth itself. Small intestine is given. So this is correct. This is wrong. Oh. Okay, proteins, pepsin. Pepsin is produced in the stomach. So here small intestine is given. So here only this is correct. The action of the digestion of starch is not complete in the mouth itself. So it continues. The amylase enzyme action. So here option C. Okay. Next, which one of the following is not a part of large intestine? Rectum, colon, cecum, duodenum. So colon, cecum, colon and rectum are the parts of large intestine. So duodenum is not the part of large intestine. It is the part of small intestine. Next, here the diagram given, large intestine diagram of man is given. Identify the parts A, B, C, D and F. A, B, C, D, E and F. So B is the appendix, vermiform appendix. A is the cecum and D is the transverse colon. C is the ascending colon and the E represent descending colon. F represent the sigmoid. These are the parts of large intestine. So here option D is correct. Okay. The gastric juice of infants contains. So this is a question appeared in the All India Pre-Medical Test 2015. So here gastric juice of infants. See, there is a, in the infants, special enzyme is present because they totally feed on the mother's milk below 1 year. Okay. An enzyme called renin is present. So here in option B and C, one is correct. Option A, amylase, renin, pepsinogen. B, maltase, pepsinogen, renin. Nuclease, pepsinogen, lipase. Pepsinogen, lipase, renin. So here option D is correct. Choose the correct pair. Renin acts on casein, milk protein. And protein is acted upon by amylase. B option. C option, carbohydrate, lipase. And maltase, lactase. So here this is wrong. This is wrong. This is wrong. So option A, renin acts on casein. Gastric juice contains. What are the enzymes present in the gastric juice? Okay. Lipase, pepsin, lipase and renin. Trypsin, lipase and renin. Trypsin, pepsin and lipase. Next, trypsin, pepsin and renin. So it is the pepsin, lipase and renin. Okay, the lipase which is present in the gastric juice, it is called as gastric lipase. In human beings, carbohydrates is stored as glycogen in liver and muscles, liver, spleen, muscles. So it's liver and muscles where the excess of glucose is stored in the form of glycogen. Where is protein digestion accomplished? Stomach, ileum, rectum, duodenum. It accomplishes in the, accomplish meaning is completes. Okay. So it completes in the ileum. Started in the stomach, completes in the ileum. Next, Bruner's glands are found in, we have discussed, they are present in the duodenum. Bruner's gland are present in duodenum. Fatty acids and glycerols are first observed by lymph vessels, adventitious roots, stem, leaf. So remaining all parts are present in the plants. Here lymph vessels, okay, lacteals called as. In the villi, these lymph vessels are present. AFMC means Armed Force Medical Colleges 1994 this question appeared. Okay, 45 lymph vessels. Wisdom teeth are last premolars, last molars, incisors, canines. So actually last molars, they are produced at the age of adolescent. Okay, next. So this question also appeared in AFMC, Armed Force Medical Colleges, previously. So HCl is a gastric juice. HCl is in the gastric juice changes. Means what is the function of hydrochloric acid present in the gastric juice? This question appeared in the MCET 1999. Pepsinogen to pepsin, prorenin to renin, disaccharides to monosaccharides, all of these. Okay, so actually hydrochloric acid performs different functions. All of these are the main function of this hydrochloric acid. Next, bilirubin is formed by the breakdown of hemoglobin, hemocyanin, hemopoietin, hematin, hemoglobin. Okay, thecodont, diphyodont and heterodont teeth are the characteristics of reptiles, aves, human beings, amphibians. So here it is the characteristic of human beings. Thecodont means the teeth which are embedded in the jaw sockets. Diphyodont, the meaning is two times the teeth appear. First is milky teeth, then permanent teeth. Then heterodont. Heterodont meaning is all the teeth are not of same structure. They are of different structures. That's why they are called heterodont. Okay, human teeth are thecodont, diphyodont and heterodont type. Okay, children. Next, which of the following is not the function of liver? Production of bile, storage of glycogen, production of insulin, detoxification. So these are all the functions only. Production of bile is the function of liver, storage of glycogen is the function of liver, detoxification. But production of insulin is not the function of liver, it is the function of pancreas. Pancreas is a mixed gland. Okay. Next, crown. Crown of teeth is cementum, dentine, enamel, both B and C. Okay, it is the crown of teeth is covered by enamel. The figure given below shows a part of the human elementary canal. Okay, that is stomach, liver, pancreas, duodenum, all the parts are there. Which of the following labeled structure produce the substances involved in the conversion of fats into fatty acids and glycerol? Okay, J and K, J and L, K and L, L and M. Okay, here lipase enzyme present in the pancreatic juice. Okay, the gastric juice, lipase help in the digestion of fats into fatty acids. So here this is also wrong. The correct one is L and M. L and M means pancreatic juice contains the lipase enzyme and the bile juice help in emulsification of fats. So L and M. Match the following teeth in the column 1 with their functions. Incisors, canines, premolars, molars, grinding, cracking, cutting, tearing. So canines help in the tearing, incisors help in the cutting of food, premolars. Premolars help in cracking, and molars help in the grinding. So here the right option is D. Okay, based on their function, the teeth are also named. Incisors are called cutting teeth, canines are called tearing teeth, premolars are called cracking teeth, molars are called grinding teeth. Okay, next, given below are the various steps involved in the animal digestion: assimilation, ingestion, absorption, digestion, adsorption. So correct sequence: the first one is ingestion, second one is digestion, third one is absorption, fourth one is assimilation, and last one is adsorption. So here the correct sequence, which one should come first? 2. Okay, 2, 4, 3, 1, 5. Next, siphoning is the mode of feeding alone in which type of animal? Siphoning: hummingbird, butterfly, ant, housefly. Siphoning is 55 question we have missed. Okay, 56. Siphoning is the method of the feeding alone in which type of animal? So siphoning means absorption. Okay, the proboscis can be thrown into the flower and it absorbs the nectar of the flower, nectar from the flower. So butterfly shows siphoning. Based on the type of food they feed, mouth parts of insects are of different types: biting and chewing, piercing and sucking, siphoning, sponging and sucking, like that. The pulp is a soft material in the tooth and it is rich in starch and sugar, nerve and blood vessels, acid and cellulose. So it is the nerves and blood vessels. It's the sensitive part of the teeth, pulp. Pulp cavity we can call it as. Match the following column 1 and column 2 and select the right option using the codes given below. Column 1: number of molar teeth in a jaw, number of premolars in a jaw, number of canines in a jaw, number of incisors in both jaws. If you remember the dental formula, then it is easy: 2123 by 2123. This is the dental formula. So according to dental formula, if we calculate number of molars in in a jaw, six molars are present. Number of premolars, there are only two premolars. And next, number of canines, number of canines are 2. Number of incisors, number of incisors 8. Okay, and what is left? Premolars are 4. So the second option is correct. Okay, next, what is the function of mucus secreted by the inner lining of stomach? It protects the lining of the stomach. Next, in grass-eating animals, ruminants, the grass is stored in a part of the stomach where the food gets converted into could. This part is, what is that part? Stomach, rumen, rumination, ruminant. It is the rumen, the part of the stomach where the food is stored. Again, may I ask the following type question? Salivary glands, liver, small intestine, amylase, stomach. Yeah, spelling mistakes are there. Salivary glands produce amylase, then liver produce bile, small intestine trypsin, and the stomach pepsin. So here option A represents the correct. Next, which enzyme is secreted by small intestine? So intestinal juice contains it is called Succus entericus, contains a group of enzymes: amylase, pepsin, trypsin, hydrochloric acid. Which enzyme is present in the small intestine? It is the trypsin. Which is the layer of the teeth below the enamel? Below the enamel, the innermost, that is dentine. Okay. Next, it is a carbohydrate and its digestion begins in the buccal cavity. It is. Okay, buccal cavity means the oral cavity, mouth. The digestion of starch starts in the mouth. Okay. Okay, children. So this is for today. The total exercise we have revised. Thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon for receiving latest updates.